So I have a very complicated PC setup, and for this I needed a desk that was just impossible to get because most of the gaming desks I found online and offline were just not big enough, and the wooden desks I used earlier were not low enough to be comfortable. So today I'll talk about how I got this custom desk made, and I really think that this is the best thing that you can get, especially considering how neat it looks while actually being more affordable than other options. Hey guys, I am Siddharth, and there is only one big negative to this desk, so let's check out if it is something that can work for you or not. So at least in India, the PC desk options available are quite limited, and even if you manage to get one of those motorized desks that you see in YouTubers' videos, their serviceability and longevity are things that have big question marks on them. So if you want something custom made, the obvious option is to get a wooden desk made, but the cost of it can easily add up to around 50 or 60,000 rupees for a desk of my size. If you want something that is made with high quality plywood and you want to have a Sunmica laminate covering on both sides. The gaming desks sold online by some brands are also quite expensive, and these desks will also just break like matchsticks compared to the desk that I got made. So the material that I finalized for my gaming desk was nanowhite marble and granite. So the top of this desk is made of a material called nanowhite marble, which is actually not a marble, and it is an artificial material that is extremely dense and strong, and it is very difficult to chip or break. It is generally used in kitchen countertops, and the great thing about it is that it doesn't get stained, it is almost impossible to scratch, and it doesn't absorb any liquids. It also looks really clean, and it also has a very nice glossy finish that will stay like this for decades. But for the base of my desk, I wanted something black to give it this very nice piano finish. So for the base, I went with granite, which is something that all of you must know about. It is also used in kitchens and bathrooms, and it is also very hard to scratch or break. But with both of these materials, the issue is that they are not polished on both of the sides because they are generally installed on cement structures. For the top, this isn't a problem as the underside will not be visible, but for the base, I went with a double layer of granite so I can have its shiny side on both sides. Deciding the height for a custom desk like this is the most important factor, and after a lot of thinking, I decided to go with a height of 25 inches, and this makes it very comfortable to game and type on, with my chair on a height that allows me to rest my legs comfortably on the floor, and I can also slide in if I want to by lowering the arms of my greensole chair. I am quite happy with this desk. I think that it looks really amazing. It is also very easy to clean, and it is also very comfortable to work on. And compared to other options that were available in ready-made and custom desk market, this was also comparatively affordable at around 35,000 rupees, which is actually quite decent for a desk of this size. Now the one big issue with this desk is that it weighs around 600 to 700 kilograms, so transporting it and installing it is not something that you will be able to do yourself. I personally had to pay around 4 or 5,000 rupees for transportation because I live in an apartment, and this obviously didn't fit in the elevator. So 4 people had to carry each piece one by one, and then they had to install it. And I also had to help them with a friend, so it takes around 6 people to install because the marble and granite pieces are just so heavy. But once you get it installed, it is also not easy to move. So if you want to shift this to another location, you may have to call 3 or 5 of your friends. But even if you have more than 2 friends who like you enough, they might not have the physical strength or expertise that is required to lift this without serious injuries. So you may have to pay around 2,000 rupees to people who will shift this for you piece by piece. Do give this video a thumbs up if you've been enjoying it so far, and you can also subscribe to the channel with bell so you don't miss out on future videos. Now this is of course not something that you can just order online. You will have to find who sells nanowhite marble and granite in your area, and then you will have to give them a plan and tell them the dimensions of it, and then they will do it for you. This is a rough diagram of dimensions of different sheets of marble and granite that I had to get made, but you can of course size it according to your needs, and you may not need double granite sheets for the base. I also got the edges of the nanowhite marble rounded off except in the area where 2 of these pieces join. I will see if I can get you guys in touch with the person I bought this from by sharing his details in the video description, and if this can be transported to your area, but you can just research around your area and reach out to whoever is selling it. It should not be that difficult. I live in the city of Udaipur in Rajasthan, India, and finding this in my city is quite easy, but if you live in a place where things take longer to transport, then the price of a desk like this is going to vary a lot because the rates per square feet of marble is going to differ a lot in different areas. But other than that, I really think that a desk like this is unbeatable. I can confidently put my heavy components on it, add very long monitor arms, and there is, of course, no flex whatsoever. It is very easy to clean and it looks great, and it is again very comfortable to work on. In winters, it does get a little cold to touch, but that is not a big deal. I also got space cut in the granite base to allow cables to pass through, so you can add things like power bricks here. Now this doesn't have any drawers in it, so I was thinking that I would get them added or I would buy pre-made drawers online, but so far I haven't felt the need for that and I used the space available to store other larger things, so it has been working quite well so far, and you can of course customize a table like this in any way that you like. So that was it for this video. Let me know what you think about a table like this in the comment section below, and if you think that it is something that is practical enough for you. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it or a thumbs down if you disliked it. Subscribe with bell, follow me on socials, check out my Amazon store. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one.